गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल, यू आर वेलकम इन संजीवनी महाविद्यालय चाकोली। दिस लेक्चर इज कंसर्न टू बीएससी सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, फिजिक्स पेपर नंबर 9, बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट सेमीकंडक्टर्स, देयर टाइप्स, पी टाइप एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर्स इन डिटेल्स। I mean P-type semiconductor majority carriers, holes, and N-type semiconductor majority carriers as electrons. These things we have seen. Now we discuss about biasing of the diode. What is meant by biasing? And what are the types of biasings, their connections, all these things we are discussing now. Biasing means what? Biasing nothing but setting of initial operating conditions, current and voltage, or an active device in an amplifier. Many electronic devices such as diodes, transistors and vacuum tubes, whose function is processing time varying signals, AC signals. But they also require steady DC current or voltage at the terminals to operate correctly. It means they require DC also. This current or voltage is nothing but a bias. AC signal applied to them is superposition on this DC bias current or voltage. So bias circuit is a position or portion of the device's circuit which supplies this steady current or voltage. So there are two types of biasings of a diode. I mean in electronics there are two types of biasings, forward biasing and reverse biasing. What is forward biasing? What is reverse biasing? And how they operate? These things we discuss. If you observe this figure, then you will come to know that this is a PN junction diode. This is a narrow depletion layer, that is junction. Here P-type and here N-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor already we have seen, majority carriers are electrons, and majority carriers in P-type semiconductor are holes, here written holes and here free electrons. Got it? And here one more thing you have to see, a potential difference is provided across this diode. In what way it is provided, that you see. Positive terminal of the battery is connected to the P-type of charge. I mean holes, and holes charge of holes is what? Positive. Positive terminal of the battery is connected to the positively charged majority carriers, whereas negative terminal of the battery is connected to the negatively charged free electrons. Whenever such a potential difference is provided across the diode, that is DC potential difference, DC voltage, it is said to be bias, that is said to be forward bias. In short, you remember, when P-type of semiconductor material is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, whereas N-type of semiconductor material is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, then it is said to be forward biasing. And in forward biasing, diode acts or it conducts, whereas in reverse biasing, it doesn't conduct. It becomes an open switch in reverse biasing. See this now figure, reverse biasing. Here P-type material, here N-type material. P-type material, majority carriers, you know, positively charged. Here N-type, negatively charged majority carriers. And here, if you come to know, or if you observe carefully, then you will come to know that negative terminal of the battery is connected to the positively charged majority carriers, that is P-type semiconductor, and positive terminal of the battery is connected to the what? N-type of semiconductor, that is negatively charged electrons. Here opposite connection is given. Such a potential difference applied across the diode is said to be reverse bias. And in reverse bias, you remember, diode doesn't conduct, it remains like an open switch. See, this is what open switch. Here also you see one more figure is shown here. Same figure is there. Here positive holes, negative terminal. Positive negative charge free electrons connected to what? Positive terminal of the battery. So this combination is said to be what? Reverse bias. Here you see, carefully observe. Here it is shown reverse bias, here it is shown forward bias. Forward and reverse bias together, two different figures are shown here. So you know this, this is symbol of diode, and this bar side electrode is said to be negative, that is cathode, and this side is said to be what? Anode. I mean this anode is positively charged, this cathode is negatively charged. Anode positively charged is connected to the what? Positive terminal of the battery. And surely the remaining negative terminal of the battery is connected to what? Negative terminal of the diode, I mean cathode, through lamp. Carefully if we observe, then you will come to know that as soon as if we on the switch, if a switch is connected here, as soon as if we on the switch, then what happens? Current propagates through this diode and diode conducts and bulb glow. This is what? Forward bias. In forward biasing, diode conducts. Whereas in reverse biasing, how it is reverse? You see negative terminal of the diode here, that is cathode, is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Assuredly, negative terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal of the battery through lamp here. So in this case, this diode acts as an open switch. So in this case, bulb will not glow. So remember, in forward bias, diode conduct; in reverse bias, diode doesn't conduct. Now what are the applications of diode? Surely there are some applications in modern electronics. A small list of diodes is shown here. Small list of applications of diodes is shown to you. One of the applications is rectifiers, clipper circuits, clamping circuits, reverse current protection circuit. Very important. In logic gates, voltage multipliers, electronic systems. In various systems, there are applications of diodes. So, rectifier means what? Diode is utilized in the rectifier circuit. And rectifier means, you know, it is a device to convert AC into DC. In this way, there are various devices in which there is utilization of diode takes place. This is about the symbol of diode. In electric circuit, that is in forward bias and reverse bias, I have shown the diodes. Here actually you see symbol. This side electrode is anode. And this arrowhead side electrode of the diode is said to be what? Cathode, and cathode is negatively charged. And practically, if we take a diode in a hand, then it is like this. Then how to handle which one is cathode and which one is anode? Easy way to know the electrodes of the diode. What is the easy path to understand the diodes, anode and cathode electrodes? If you observe such a portion of on the diode that is said to be ring, we say such a white ring is there. This side electrode is said to be what? Cathode, and this one is said to be anode. In this way, practically you can identify, in case of diode, this is symbol, and actually diode is like this. So practically, while handling the electronic, component diode, one has to observe ring, and that ring side electrode is cathode, and other electrode is said to be what? It is anode. In this way, easily you can identify which one is cathode and which one is anode. Now let us start very important one more component, that is junior diode. This is about only diode. Now, what is junior diode? What are its application? What is its symbol? How it is connected? How it conducts? In what biasing it conducts? These terms you should know in details. So, junior diode is a special type of diode designed reliably, which allows current to flow backwards when a certain set reverse voltage known as junior voltage is reached. I mean, from this it is clear that junior diode will conduct in a reverse biasing only. Junior potential difference is supposed given, then only it will conduct. It will allow to flow electric current through it. So, if we carefully observe this figure, then you will come to know this is a schematic symbol of junior diode. Here, this is said to be cathode. Here, Z shape is shown here. In case of diode, it was not Z shaped. Cathode we can identify like this in that symbol. And here, Z is shown here. This symbol Z stands for what? This is the symbol of junior diode, and this is cathode. This electrode is what? Anode. Direction of normal current, direction of normal diode current flow is like this. Here its appearance is, practically if we take in hand, then it will appear like this. Then how to identify either it's this electrode is positive and this electrode is negative, which one is negative and which one is positive. So in the same way, like this our diode ring, we have to observe ring side electrode cathode, and the remaining other electrode is what? Surely anode. In this way also, in this figure you carefully observe, there is a ring. This is a ring shown on the body, and this ring is towards this electrode. That's why this electrode is negative. I mean, this is cathode and this one is what? Anode. Got it? Good. Now in figure this, you see positive terminal is shown here. It is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, negative terminal of the diode, junior diode, and negative terminal of this battery is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. So junior diode and junior voltage, a regulator calculator. So using this junior diode in reverse biasing, we obtain a regulated circuit. What is meant by regulated circuit? This is also a question maybe with you. So what is its regulation means what? How it is regulated? Here variable voltage source is shown here, and here regulated output is shown here. Variable in the sense there is a what? Slight variation in the input voltage. If we vary input voltage to a certain limit, output remains constant. Output remains constant, that is said to be what? Regulated output. Either there is a decrease in voltage or increase in voltage to a certain limit, up to a certain limit, we will obtain a regulated, I mean constant output across this junior diode. And this constant output is nothing but the good turn of this component, that is junior diode. As it is working in reverse bias, as it is connected in reverse bias, so we are getting what? Regulated, I mean constant output across this diode. And this constant output is very important for our electronic gadgets. Then, see now, these are the various power supplies for our electronic gadgets depending upon the requirement of the potential difference of the gadget. Here we have different power supplies, and these power supplies are made with the help of what? Junior diode. And in these power supplies, junior diode acts as a regulator, and these power supplies are said to be what? Regulated power supplies. Now let us take